Isaiah 6 says here, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on the throne on high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above it stood seraphim. So that's the temple, right? He's looking at the Lord, he's getting a vision, and he's looking at the temple, and he sees angels. And it says here, he sees seraphim, each one had six wings, two covered his face, two had covered feet, and two he flew, and he cried to another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. So then what happens is, the posts of the door were shaken by the voice of him who cried out. The house was filled with smoke. So look at what he said. Let's imagine what's happening. Isaiah is having a vision. He's looking at the Lord, his vision. He said that the Lord is filling the temple, right? So what happens is he's filling the temple, and he's looking at it, and he sees the holiness of God. But look what he said. He said, woe is me. Woe is me, for I'm undone. I'm undone. So woe is me. I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips. And I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. So let's check it out what happens. He sees the Lord in a vision. He sees all these angels, and he realizes, man, woe is me, I'm a man of unclean lips. But why? Because who can be in the presence of the Lord? Who can be in the presence of the Lord and not realize how unclean they are? Because God is so holy. And so when you stand before the Lord, he said, woe is me, I'm a man of unclean lips. Because the presence of God doesn't. Most men and women come before the Lord, they fall on their face. And they fall on their face because God is so holy. And we are sinful. But here's the good news, guys. Here's the good news of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ can forgive you of your sins, but you gotta put faith in Jesus Christ. You have to put faith in Jesus Christ. It's only faith in Jesus Christ can we receive the grace of God. Without Jesus Christ, there is no grace of God. And look what he says here. He says, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is filled with glory. And he sees the host shaking, the voice of him crying out, and the house was full of smoke. Just imagine that scene. Imagine. We're human. We can't even fathom heaven. But this is a scene where the whole temple of God is filled with smoke. God is holy. There's angels everywhere. And he's just normal, mortal human being. And he's saying, whoa! Woe is me! I'm a man of unclean lips. I'm looking at something holy. Because like I said, you cannot see the presence of God without being affected, without looking at how clean you are. But let me ask you this. How many of you guys keep hearing the same message that I'm preaching? Because this is not the first time you guys heard this. I'm sure of that. So let me ask you, how can you continue in the presence of God? And Isaiah said, woe is me. Are you saying woe is me? Are you saying it? Are you recognizing the holiness of God? Or are you just continuing your sins and not even caring about what is going on in your life? But I'm here to tell you, God loves you, sister. And I believe that with all my heart. God loves you, brother. He loves you. He loves each and every one of you. And I believe that with all my heart. I'm telling you that Jesus Christ loves you. I don't care whether you feel like you're worthy or you feel like you're worthy. We're all worthy because he died on the cross once and for all of us to have redemption in Jesus Christ. Notice I said in Jesus, because without Jesus, we got nothing. It's only through Jesus Christ that we have grace. It's only through Jesus Christ, and that's why I'm here. Why else would I be here? Come on. You think I'm going to be here? It's only because I love God, because one day, I'll tell you what, I was in the same position you guys. I wasn't. Okay? Not in Miami, Florida, so Miami. I'll tell you what, the Lord Jesus Christ changed my life. But I had to be willing to submit myself to the Lord. I had to be willing to say, I'm going to become less, and he's going to become more in my life. The question is, are you willing? How many of you are truly willing God loves you.